So it looks like we love the Nexus 5 so much that Google had to go and make another one. This is the Nexus 5X. So first, let's unbox this thing and see what you get when you pick this guy up. First thing you're greeted with is a card that shows you everything you get inside and what to do with it. Move past that and you'll find all your typical accessories. However, this time around, we've got a USB Type-C cable. And this cable is awesome because it's completely reversible, gives you faster data transfer speeds, and most importantly, allows you to charge your phone faster. And with that, we've got a wall adapter, which you'll notice is sporting the USB Type-C port. You definitely want to make sure you don't lose these. We've also got a small packet that houses the SIM removal tool, as well as the paperwork that you know you won't read. But onto the main attraction, the Nexus 5X. After removing the wrap it came in, the first thing I noticed was how light this thing is. The feel in the hand is very similar to that of the original Nexus 5. It has a soft touch back, which feels pretty good, but just like the original Nexus 5, the soft touch back will show wear over time, as you can see here. If this is something that bothers you, I definitely suggest getting a case or skin to go with it. And even though this thing has a 5.2 inch display, it doesn't feel large at all, and that's great for everyday things like storing it away in your pocket, using it to talk on the phone, texting, and whatever else you'd plan to do with it. And speaking of the display, we're working with a 1080p screen, and unlike the Nexus 6P, which has an AMOLED display, the 5X is rocking LCD. Now this translates to a slightly less vibrant display, but honestly, with day-to-day use, it'll be just fine, and I've been able to watch movies with no problem, but if you go ahead and compare it side-by-side to an AMOLED display, you'll most likely see the difference. Now taking a look around the rest of the device shows us that we've got a few buttons on the right side. On top, you'll find the power button, and below it, the volume controls. Below the phone, you'll find the headphone jack and the USB Type-C port, and up front we've got a 5 megapixel front facing camera and what looks like stereo speakers, but there's actually only one at the bottom. And I gotta admit, I'm a bit disappointed considering it looks like there are stereo speakers, and I think every smartphone today should have front facing stereo speakers, and sadly this doesn't. Moving on to the back, we've got that nice big Nexus logo and a 12 megapixel camera, as well as that fingerprint scanner. The fingerprint scanner was actually really easy to set up, and I'm a fan of its placement on the back of the phone. You won't be able to use it when it's resting down on a surface, but that's not a big deal to me. It's very quick, and I love that I can turn the phone on and unlock it without even having to hit any buttons. And after a while, it becomes instinctive to just go and reach for the back of the phone, and I found myself doing that to other phones that didn't even have the feature. Now, we've covered the hardware, but what about the software? This guy is running Android 6.0 Marshmallow, and as a Nexus device, this thing is running stock Android, so you're getting the cleanest experience Google has to offer. And of course, since this is a Nexus device, it's one of Google's flagship phones, you're gonna get access to all the updates as soon as they're available. It's a solid performer in the $400 price range, and the lack of useless add-ons from carriers and manufacturers helps to keep it clean and running smoothly. Google did introduce a few notable features with Marshmallow, such as Now on Tap, which scans your screen and pulls up information based on text available. This kind of feature is great if someone mentions something you're unfamiliar with and you quickly want to look it up. And while it's definitely a cool feature, it's kind of hit or miss. But when it does work, it's pretty awesome because you can pull up actors, artists, restaurants, and of course more, and it'll spit things back like a normal Google search, Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram accounts, news, and tons of other options. This is definitely gonna be a really solid feature once it grows a bit more. And the second notable feature is Doze. Now, the Nexus 5 has decent battery life. It'll probably get you through the day depending on how heavy of a user you are, but that's probably because of the extra help you're getting from the Doze feature. Now, what Doze does is it actually uses the sensors within the phone, and when you put it down, it'll actually recognize that you're not using it. It'll turn the phone into like a hibernation state, which will decrease the amount of refreshes that applications will go through, and with that, you're able to actually save on some battery life. And when you go to pick it up or use it, it's actually gonna take off Doze and you're gonna have everything running as normal. Definitely an awesome feature for those who aren't power users, people who just casually take the phone and use it every once in a while. This is gonna be awesome because you're gonna get that awesome standby time. Now, of course, we gotta talk about the camera quality. The 5X is actually sporting the same exact camera as the Nexus 6P, which actually turns out to be a pretty decent shooter. And cameras have always been a spot that the Nexus phones have struggled with, so it's good to see some improvements here. The quality has been pretty on point, and I found that in low light, the shots tend to be a bit on the grainy side, But when you throw on HDR Plus, it is like night and day, or night and better night. But either way, it's a better version with HDR Plus. I definitely saw a huge difference when using that. So overall, it's a pretty solid performer. I wouldn't expect to see Galaxy Note 5 kind of quality or LG G4, but with this, you're gonna get some decent shots, and considering this is a $400 phone, you can't be upset. And I feel like that's the overall theme of the Nexus 5X. It's not a crazy powerhouse like the Galaxy Note 5, but you're getting a way more budget-friendly option that starts at $379, and considering it's a Nexus device, you've got a smooth, very fluid experience. And while the battery life and the camera may not be top-notch, it's still very good for its price range. I can't imagine anybody being upset with it unless they come from one of those powerhouse phones. But that's about it for this review, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed it. The Nexus 5X gets my recommendation if you're looking for something that's budget-friendly and just works well. But hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Till then, it's your average consumer. Peace.